我们先跟大家大概讲一下 Zoom 里面有一些互动的小工具，在最下面的工具栏有一个回应的按钮，上面有一个小表情，画了一个加号，可以点击那个按钮给我们发送一些鼓掌啊或者其他的手势的互动。对，也可以在聊天框里面随时发一些问题，我们会有线下工作人员来收集这些问题，等一下会有嘉宾统一回答，而且是有奖问答环节。好的，那各位区块链生态的家人们，大家好，欢迎大家参加 EOS 网络基金会举办的首次线上见面会活动。我是本次活动的主持人兼双语翻译，我叫 Daisy。那今天的会上我们请到了两位重量级嘉宾，欢迎大家积极和我们互动。刚才说了，您可以使用 Zoom 发送一些表情的功能，还可以跟我们进行有奖提问来互动。您现在就可以把想到的问题随时随地打进聊天框，用中文答，用英文问都可以。当然如果是双语对照的就更好了。我们会有工作人员持续收集大家的问题，等一下在 QA 环节会统一作答。问题被选中回答的提问者是可以拿到奖金的哦。大家现在就可以积极思考起来了。从现在开始一直到问答环节结束，全程如果您想到任何问题都可以随时发上来。那好了，我们就正式开始本次活动。我先来简单跟大家介绍一下 EOS 网络基金会的诞生背景。 EOS 网络自诞生以来一直都被誉为是孕育杀手级 DAPP 的理想沃土，但是稳定运营三年有余， EOS 网络好像并没有释放其作为明星项目的潜力。究其原因呢， EOS 需要更强有力的领导力量，构建基础设施建设，捕捉市场发展趋势，并应对瞬息万变的市场做出及时的响应，给予具有创新想法的开发者以技术、资金和运营方面的支持与建议。就是在这样的背景下， EOS 网络基金会应运而生，作为 EOS 的生态协作、决策和信息共享平台， EOS 网络基金会自成立两个月以来始终保持公开、科学、高效的工作节奏。相信今天参会的很多朋友都已经在各大媒体上看到了340万美元首批资助项目的计划相关消息，也看到了 EOS 网络基金会和 Pomelo EdenOS 的合作，共同推动建立更高效、公开透明、民主、去中心化的 EOS 生态决策治理平台。基于以上种种，我们举办了本次社区线上见面会活动。在本次见面会中， EOS 网络基金会的 Executive Director Yves La Rose 还有 Communications Director Zach Gall 将为我们分享 EOS 网络基金会近期的发展规划、下一批的资助计划、项目筛选条件等等各项消息动态。另外我们还采取了定向邀约的方式，邀请来自社区的150多位区块生态链领军人物还有 KOLs 齐聚一堂，和大家一起共同聆听 EOS 网络基金会的发展规划，来描绘 EOS 生态全貌还有未来蓝图。也非常感谢大家在百忙之中在中国的深夜抽出时间来参加本次的活动，感恩。为了表示诚意，我们在本次活动最后也设置了提问互动环节，大家可以自由发问。我看到有一些朋友已经把问题打上来了，等一下 Eve 和 Zach 会挑选问题进行回答，被选中回答为幸运提问者，每人可以获得50 EOS 的奖励。另外为了感谢区块链生态各位嘉宾对于 EOS S 的社区的关注和积极参与，每一位参加本次活动的参会嘉宾都可以获得20 EOS 的奖励。与此之外，为纪念见面会的顺利召开，每一位参会嘉宾还将于元旦前后获得由 EOS 网络基金会精心准备的重磅神秘跨年大礼。非常感谢各位的参加，是不是很期待呢？那我们话不多说，就直接进入本次见面会的第一个环节， 让我们来欢迎 EOS 网络基金会的 Executive Director Yves La Rose 为大家分享他创建 EOS 网络基金会的初衷， EOS 网络基金会下一批资助计划详情，以及 EOS 网络基金会未来一年的发展规划路线图。Now I'll give the floor to the Executive Director of EOS Network Foundation, Yves La Rose, to give us an introduction of the status quo and future vision of the foundation.To you, Yves.
Thank you very much, Daisy. And hello, everybody. I thank you very much for coming today. I'm very pleased to be able to speak with you all today and give you an update on what the EOS Network Foundation has been doing over the last 2 months. Essentially, what we've been doing is repositioning and positioning EOS, the EOS ecosystem, towards the future, essentially rebuilding a vision that has largely been lost over the last couple of years.I think it's important to give you a little bit of context and background to address the current situation and to assess what went wrong over the last few years. But more importantly, how we plan on taking what we've learned so that we may move towards where we may want to be, so that EOS is more fruitful and more sustainable in terms of growth. There's no sugarcoating it. EOS, as it stands, is a failure. The last 3 years or so have been nothing but dwindling in terms of market cap and in terms of token value.EOS has been a terrible investment. It's been a terrible financial, time, and community investment. The reality is that many people no longer want to be associated with EOS because of its tarnished reputation. EOS, as it stands, is a failure.
大家好，非常感谢大家参与 EOS 网络基金线上见面会活动。我很荣幸能够向在座各位分享全新的 EOS 网络基金会在过去两个月所做的工作，重新定位，朝向未来，弥补过去几年出现的过失。我觉得需要给大家提供一些背景来分析过去几年出现的问题。我们认识到问题很重要，但是总结经验，制定目标，寻找 EOS 生态可持续发展的道路更为重要。这里没有什么糖衣炮弹的包装，实话实说， EOS 目前的发展可以说是挺失败的。在过去3年左右的时间里，市值和币值价值都一直在下降。相较于其他的加密货币而言， EOS 可以说被视为一个比较糟糕的投资，糟糕的资金，糟糕的时间和社区投资。面对声誉受损的 EOS， 众多 EOS 持币者甚至都感到失望，并逐渐放弃继续持有 EOS。 目前来说， EOS 确实是挺失败的。
Since stepping down as CEO of EOS Nation, I had the opportunity to take a step back and reassess where we've been and how we got here.It's very clear to me that EOS was a victim of its own success. The token sale for EOS shattered and broke all previous records in terms of funds raised. This put EOS in a position of having to meet extreme expectations as it raised extreme sums. A large part of the token sale success can be attributed to the commitments that Block.One made. At this point, it's the consensus of most token holders that I speak to, inside and outside of EOS, that Block.One knowingly misrepresented their capabilities, and this amounts to negligence and fraud. EOS is now in a state where, regardless of what it does, it's weighed down by the failed commitments and the failures of Block.One. It's apparent that Block.One is pretending it can add value to EOS, and it dangles this pretense in order to quell any potential uprising.They've largely moved away from wanting to contribute, and their EOS is more of a liability than it is an asset. It's a liability on the legal front, on the media front, and it's liability in terms of overall finances. This is not to say that some internal to Block.One aren't wishing to add value, but the machine is not focused on EOS in any meaningful sense. The shareholders of Block.One are not the same as the EOS token holders, and we find ourselves in a position.Where we're weighed down by an entity that doesn't even want to be here. What we're experiencing is a shift whereby the EOS community is placing itself in a position to be able to move away from Block.One, essentially forking them out. Until this formal shift occurs, Block.One will simply continue weighing EOS down. To the greater blockchain ecosystem, EOS is Block.One. Block.One is fraudulent. Therefore, EOS is fraudulent.The reality for those within the ecosystem is that we have also reached consensus and agree with this assessment that they're fraudulent. Block.One were negligent and overstated their capabilities. This break is needed for a narrative and branding shift to occur. So there's a clear delineation that EOS does not equal Block.One. If they truly cared, they should welcome this approach as the next optimal play that should be done. If this is a chess game, They should agree that this is the best move for all. If the idea is to win as a team, this is the next move. Until then, all efforts that we do within the ecosystem are largely overshadowed by this weight that bears down on the ecosystem. They should recognize that there's another entity that's better suited to run these operations.
自从卸任 EOS Nation 的首席执行官以来，我有机会后退一步，深刻反思我们的经历以及我们是如何走到今天的。我很清楚 ，EOS 其实是自身成功的受害者。EOS 的代币销售打破了先前筹集资金的所有记录，因为筹集到了前所未有的高额资金，导致众人对 EOS 寄予了前所未有的高希望，而 EOS 也不得不满足各种极高的期望条件。EOS 代币销售的很大一部分都归功于 Block.One 的承诺。我与 EOS 内外的大多数代币持有者的想法一致，就是 Block.One 故意歪曲了他们自身的能力，这既是一种疏忽行为，也可以说是一种欺诈行为。EOS 现在处于一种状态，也就是无论他做什么，他都会被 Block.One 的失败所拖累。很明显 ，Block.One 假装自己可以为 EOS 增加价值，并以此作为平息任何潜在抗议的手段，但实际上他基本上已经不想要再做什么贡献了。他们的 EOS 与其说是一种资产，不如说是一种负债，这是法律方面的责任，媒体方面的责任，也是整体财务方面的责任。这并不意味着说 Block.One 内部的人员不希望增加价值，而是 Block.One 并没有一门心思专门专注于 EOS 的发展。Block.One 的股东和 EOS 代币持有者不一样，我们发现自己正在被一个和我们不是一条心的实体所拖累。我们现在正在经历的是一个蜕变阶段，也就是从 EOS 把 EOS 从 Block.One 中独立出来的过程，把它们分叉出去。只要蜕变不发生， Block.One 就会可能会继续拖累 EOS。 在这种转变正式发生之前， EOS 还隶属于 Block.One，因此当 Block.One 被人们认为是欺诈性的，以此类推， EOS 也是具有欺诈性的。所以对于 EOS 生态中的人来说，我们其实已经达成了一种共识，他们是有欺诈性的，这没有问题。 Block.One 玩忽职守，而且夸大其词，所以我们想要打破这种局面，就需要依靠一个领导者和一个新的基金会的出现。因此这也得出一个很明确的划分，也就是我们要明确界限， EOS 并不等同于 Block.One。 如果他们关心整个 EOS 的生态利益，他们就应该支持这个促进 EOS 生态可持续发展的最优方案。我们打个比方，假如说这是一场国际象棋比赛，纵观整个棋面，他们就应该同意我们走的是一步好棋，要想追求团队共赢，我们就必须走这一步。在此之前，我们在 EOS 生态内所做出的种种努力，有些已经付诸东流。 Block.One 目前最需要做的就是赞同并支持我们的方案，因为我们已经帮他们布好了棋子，走好了下一步棋，他们只需要顺水推舟就好。他们应该认识到我们这个实体更适合去做这些工作。
When I decided to pursue the launch of the EOS Network Foundation back in August, I did so with the mindset that the EOS community needed to take matters in its own hands to move towards a future where EOS regains leadership within the greater blockchain ecosystem. The software itself is extremely performant, but very few people are aware of this, and EOS largely works within its own sandbox. EOS was quickly branded by its competitors as a centralized chain, and this worked very well for them, as it resulted in the network becoming further decentralized to a fault to counter the narrative that was being placed on it. The structures within EOS were chaotic due to true decentralization at an early stage. Our issue has not been decentralization, but the lack of centralization, a centralized entity that could support the ecosystem in a way that only a centralized entity could. Most other blockchains launched with a foundation. EOS is the only valued ecosystem that did not, but now has a foundation born out of decentralization. The EOS Network Foundation is a direct result of the holes and gaps that have been created over the last 3 years and is unique in this regard. This has tremendous potential. The creation of the EOS Network Foundation at this time enables EOS to be extremely efficient, focused, and resolved in its capital deployment and vision creation.
当我决定在八月份启动 EOS 网络基金会时，我的心态是 EOS 社区需要自己解决问题。 未来 EOS 应该在更大的区块链生态系统中重新获得领导地位。其实我们本身软件性能非常好，但很少有人意识到这一点，而且 EOS 往往只是自顾自地在自己的小天地里默默耕耘。EOS 很快就被竞争对手贴上了中心化的标签，这对他们来说是很奏效的，因为它导致网络进一步去中心化，从而出现故障，再以此作为抨击 EOS 的手段。在早期阶段 ，EOS 内部结构是很混乱的。我们关键的问题其实不是去中心化，而是缺乏中心化，去做一些只有中心化实体才能支撑 EOS 生态的可持续发展工作。大部分的区块链都成立了自己的基金会，而 EOS 是唯一一个有价值基础却没有基金会的区块链生态。目前 EOS 已经成功建立了一个去中心化为基础的网络基金会。 EOS 网络基金会的成立直接弥补了过去三年中的差距和漏洞，从这个角度上讲，它是独一无二的，也是不可替代的。此时此刻创建的 EOS 网络基金会蕴藏着无穷的生命力，使得 EOS 在它的资金部署和愿景创建上都能够极其的高效、专注和果决。
To an extent, we're fortunate in EOS because we can learn from what others have done and others have come before us have done. When it comes to what is needed to lay the foundations for a thriving ecosystem, we have others to look towards and model off. We currently have funding and momentum that can be deployed to amplify and to accelerate these strengths. Over the past 2 months, the EOS Network Foundation has positioned itself administratively, legally, technically, and financially to be able to stop the bleeding that is occurring in the EOS ecosystem. It has positioned itself to help EOS start running in the right direction again, to catch up to the rest of the blockchain ecosystem that has largely left EOS behind. The EOS Network Foundation is empowered to execute on its mandate of enabling developers, businesses, and individuals to build on EOS. EOS.io is a very powerful piece of software that is battle-tested and extremely performant. Our issue is not lack of technology. Our issue is not lack of supply. The issue that we must address is the lack of demand, and part of this lack of demand comes from the branding that weighs us down. The EOS Network Foundation is now in a position to form strong partnerships with key opinion leaders and media partners such as yourselves to amplify the work that's being done daily by developers, businesses, and individuals within our ecosystem in order to help reposition and rebrand EOS as a blockchain environment of choice for investors. The EOS Network Foundation is serious in its resolve to attract investors.
EOS 网络基金会可以说是很幸运的，因为我们有很多前车之鉴，有许多前人的经验可以吸取。在讨论如何构建 EOS 的生态社区时，我们有先例，有范本。EOS 网络基金会已经逐步形成了资金和动力，可以扩大和加速我们的优势。在过去两个月， EOS 网络基金会在行政、法律、技术和资金层面都进行了各种的重新定位和探索，以避免重蹈覆辙。正确的定位使得 EOS 生态能重新踏上光明的道路，大踏步地追赶上其他区块链生态系统。基金会授权给 EOS 开发者、企业和个人，让他们来构建整个 EOS 生态。众所周知，我们的 EOS.io 是一个很强大的区块链软件，经过实战测试，而且性能很好。因此 ，EOS 网络基金会急需解决的问题，不是在于缺乏技术，也不在于缺乏供给，而是在于缺乏需求。导致需求不足的其中一个原因，就是我之前提到的品牌塑造问题。EOS 网络基金会有望重拾投资者的信心，基金会正在和关键领袖，包括媒体朋友，就比如说参会的各位，建立更加牢固的合作伙伴关系，加强开发者、企业和个人之间的关系纽带，以重新来定位 EOS， 使其成为区块链投资者的首选环境。EOS 网络基金会也非常重视和吸引投资者。
In the last 2 months, the EOS Network Foundation has been able to set the baseline for the EOS ecosystem to move it towards where it can redeploy and execute on a new vision and have a roadmap where stakeholders can see themselves within that vision. EOS has been lacking vision since the token sale. There's been no white paper, yellow paper, or overall published roadmap of any worth. When attracting developers, businesses, individuals, and investors, these are extremely important as it gives a sense of direction. It lays out how we plan on getting there and how stakeholders fit within that vision. More importantly, it opens the door for these stakeholders to contribute towards that vision. Without a vision and without a roadmap, it's extremely difficult for people to have hope for the future and want to join an ecosystem. All they can do is imagine for themselves what that vision may be, and we've seen that this is chaotic and leads to a downfall. The EOS Network Foundation takes this responsibility extremely seriously and has been engaging with key stakeholders to lay out this vision. As I mentioned earlier, we're fortunate to be able to have others within the greater blockchain ecosystem that have created a path for us to be able to model off. One of those entities that I admire is Consensus and Ethereum. The EOS Network Foundation is modeling some of its pillars on their products to have as public good pillars available to all. I call these pillars because they will support everything that's built on top of them. These pillars will lay out four blue papers that will in tandem form a very detailed and expansive component of the overall roadmap for EOS.
在过去的两个月中 ,EOS 网络基金会进行了重新的定位，明确使命，也制定了一个发展路线图，让每一位利益相关者都可以在这个愿景中找到自己的位置。自代币销售以来 ,EOS 缺乏一个明确的使命和愿景，也就是没有任何有价值的白皮书、黄皮书或者任何发表的战略指南都没有。这些对于 EOS 如何实现目标和吸引开发者、企业、个人、投资者参与其中，其实起着至关重要的作用，因为他们提供了方向性的指引，并阐述了我们应该计划如何实现这些目标，以及利益相关者们在其中占有什么样的位置。如果没有愿景，没有路线图，人们也就很难为它的发展抱有什么希望，导致最后人们只愿意作为旁观者，而不会真正加入 EOS 生态。人们所能做的也就只有自行脑补，而我们已经看到这样只会导致混乱。EOS 网络基金会高度重视这一问题，积极与各方利益相关者讨论，并且确定了 EOS 的愿景。正如我刚才提到的 ,EOS 网络基金会其实挺幸运，因为在更大的区块链生态系统中，前人已经为我们铺好了一些道路。其中我很钦佩的一个项目就是来自以太坊的 Consensus。EOS 网络基金会也正在对其部分支柱进行建模，以构建所有人都可以使用的区块链公共产品作为支柱。我们将列出四份蓝皮书，他们将细致而广泛地构成整个 EOS 的路线图。
I want to take the time to delve into a little bit more detail so you have a better understanding of what I mean when I mention pillars. We currently have four pillars, four working groups that are being formed and should be formally announced in the next coming weeks. They will lay the foundations for the technical roadmap for EOS. The final names of those working groups are still in draft, but they've been labeled as Audit Plus,Wallet Plus, Docu Plus, and API Plus in the interim. They are teams of individuals that have been appointed by the EOS Network Foundation. They are subject matter experts within their own realm that have been contributing to EOS and have showcased that they're capable of and are willing to do the work that is required of them to lead us forward. Each of the four working groups has been tasked with creating a blue paper over the next 8 to 12 weeks. What I call a blue paper is a blend of components that are traditionally found in a white paper,a yellow paper, a request for proposal, and a roadmap. The aim is to publish these four papers prior to the upcoming Chinese New Year.
我想花点时间深入跟大家谈一谈，让您更好理解我刚才介绍的这个支柱具体指什么。我们目前有四大支柱，正在组建的四个工作组也将会在下周正式宣布。他们将会为 EOS 的技术路线图奠定基础。这些工作组的最终名称还没有最终确定，暂时就把它们并称为 Audit Plus、Wallet Plus、Docu Plus 还有 API Plus。他们就是 EOS 网络基金会任命的团队和个人，都是区块链各个领域的专家，一直在为 EOS 做出自己的贡献。他们都有能力并且有意愿展开工作，带领 EOS 网络基金会不断前行。每一个工作组都会在接下来的8到12周内提交一份蓝皮书。这里的蓝皮书指的是传统意义上的白皮书、黄皮书，还有有效提案、规划蓝图等四者的有机结合。它的目标就是在2022年的农历新年之前发表完成四篇论文。
Another thing to note in terms of the roadmap is that we can no longer rely on Block.One to support and guide development. They've lost all key developers and have pivoted away from being a blockchain development company towards being an asset management company.It's inevitable that the EOS Network Foundation will need to manage the EOS IO codebase going forward. However, we don't plan on doing so in a similar fashion to what Block.One has been doing. They've been focusing on features required for their own products and operations, not ours. The problem with this is that whenever a feature or priority for EOS token holders doesn't align with theirs, the issue is never addressed. And as EOS token holders are not Block.One shareholders, there's a misalignment of incentives. One of the ways that we've seen this manifest itself over the years is that no Chinese developers had the opportunity to get their PRs merged by Block.One, despite Chinese developers being numerous and talented. The EOS Network Foundation is moving towards a model very similar to Ethereum, where there are multiple core development teams instead of one. The EOS Network Foundation will serve as the coordination and allocation of capital for the overall development function. We will incentivize multiple core developer teams to form and to bring about the changes to the code base that they believe are necessary for the EOS network. This will translate into further collaboration and the growth of the EOS family instead of the current segregation and working in silo. We see our role manifesting itself very similarly to what we see in other blockchains where foundations present the visions and roadmap. On top of this, the EOS Network Foundation would coordinate different merges of code and present the resulting recommendations to the block producers. So we have more consistent and more frequent updates. The priority was highlighted early and steps have already been taken towards this inevitable future.
值得注意的是，就路线图而言，我们不能再依赖 Block.One 来支持和引导 EOSIO 的发展。他们已经失去了所有关键的开发者，已经从一家区块链开发公司转向了资产管理公司。EOS 网络基金会不可避免的需要管理 EOSIO 的代码库，但是我们不打算用 Block.One 的老方法，因为他们之前只关注自己的产品和运营所需要的功能，而并不关注我们的需求。每当 EOS 持币者需要的功能或者优先级和他们有冲突，这个问题就永远不会得到解决。并且由于 EOS 持币者不是 Block.One 的股东，双方的出发点总是有所分歧。这其中一个表现就是，尽管中国开发者众多而且才华横溢，但仍没有任何中国开发者能让他们的 PR 被 Block.One 合并。EOS 网络基金会正朝着一个类似于以太坊的模式来发展，我们有多个核心开发团队共同组成。EOS 网络基金会将作为整体开发功能的资金协调者和分配者。此外呢，基金会还会鼓励建设多个核心开发团队来优化 EOSIO 网络所必要的代码库，这将大大促进 EOS 生态之间的有机结合，发展 EOS 大家庭，而不是像现在这样孤立的运作。以此推动 EOS 生态的发展呢， EOS 网络基金会和其他区块链的基金会一样，都是为生态勾勒出明确的愿景和清晰的路线图。在这样的基础之上， EOS 网络基金会还会协调不同代码之间的合并，并将新代码报送给区块链生产者，保持代码更新的一致性和时效性。这个需求的优先级很早就被强调了，也已经开展了行动。
It's important to highlight and to recognize that we're running from behind. Over the last 3 years, EOS has squandered away a lot of the lead that it had prior to launch. When the EOS Network Foundation was launched, we understood very quickly that we didn't have the luxury to be able to operate vertically. What I mean by vertically is working on one project at a time, one after another. What we've chosen to do by necessity is to work horizontally, meaning that we're firing on all cylinders at once. We're working on multiple projects all at once, multiple priorities in tandem, in concurrence, in the same fashion that a multi-core, multi-threaded CPU operates. We're moving ahead at an extremely rapid pace. The advantage is to be able to deliver consistently and continuously. We're aware that when a project is undertaken, it may sometimes take months before tangible results are seen. Running on multiple fronts in parallel is what effective corporations do. And this is the approach that we're taking. It's important to note that the EOS Network Foundation is very much aiming to run the EOS Network as a business.
我们需要意识到我们现在处于落后的位置，在过去三年里 EOS 错失了许多领先优势。 EOS 网络基金会目前所做的就是要奋起直追。 EOS 网络基金会成立之初，我们很快就意识到基金会还不具备垂直运作的能力。这里所说的垂直运作是指一次只处理一个项目，一个项目接一个项目的处理。基金会选择的是水平运作模式，也就是同时处理多个项目，多个优先事项同时进行。 这就像许多多线程 CPU 的运作模式一样， EOS 网络基金会正在以前所未有的速度来前进。这样的优势在于能够持续且准确的交付。我们知道一个项目从开始实施一直到看到切实的成果，中间可能需要几个月的时间，而多线程的运作是高效公司的运作方式，也是我们要采取的运作方式。这里想要强调的是， EOS 网络基金会将 EOS 网络视为最重要的一项业务，并全力以赴。
Regarding funding, we must continue supporting the rest of the ecosystem through funding as we've done over the last couple of weeks. For example, our $100,000 recognition grant initiative generated quantifiable positive results. Over $3 million worth of investments went and will go to teams within our ecosystem that have consistently demonstrated love for EOS. To add to this, the EOS Network Foundation contributed roughly $2 million to the development and the first iteration of Eden, which held its first election in October. I've been very satisfied with the results so far. I monitor closely and I see a lot of potential in this initiative. I'm excited to see China create its first Eden as well, and I already see many working towards this goal. I invite all of you to participate in the Chinese iteration of Eden. The EOS Network Foundation commits to financially supporting this initiative once it's in a state to accept funding. So far, the EOS Network Foundation has committed and deployed over $7 million directly back into EOS since its creation. We've already started to lay the foundations of funding mechanisms accessible to EOS community members. This is only the beginning as we formalize our grant framework that will lead us forward towards more frequent and larger investments. We've already been approached by venture capitalists looking to invest in EOS to the tunes of $150 to $200 million of extra capital. Think about that.
在资金方面， EOS 网络基金会会像过去几周所做的那样，继续通过资金来支持 EOS 生态的其他项目。比如说，我们$10万的表彰资助计划产生了可以量化的积极成果，超过$300万的投资已经发出，并且即将流向我们生态系统中热爱 EOS 的团队。除此之外， EOS 网络基金会为 Eden 的开发和第一次迭代贡献了大约$200万。Eden 于十月举行了第一次选举，到目前为止我对这些结果都非常满意。我密切关注所有的资助项目，也看到了每一个项目蕴含的巨大潜力。我很高兴看到中国也建立了 EOS 的第一个 Eden， 我看到了许多人都在朝着这个目标努力，因此我也热烈欢迎其他人的加入。一旦这个项目到了接受资金的阶段， EOS 网络基金会也会承诺提供资金支持。到目前为止，EOS 网络基金会自创立以来已经承诺并直接向 EOS 生态投放了超过$700万的资助。EOS 网络基金会为 EOS 生态社区建立起来了一个资金的机制，但这只是一个开始，因为我们需要正式确定资助框架，并且以此来推动 EOS 完成更频繁和更大规模的投资。EOS 基金会已经在风险投已经和一些风险投资家达成了初步协议，并讨论了以$1.5亿到$2亿的额外资本来注资 EOS， 这可以说是非常可观啊。
EOS historically has had very poor branding and marketing. We've touched upon certain reasons this has been the case earlier in the discussion. Working on branding and marketing is something that we've highlighted as a top priority, and we've deployed considerable resources to early on.I'm very excited to share that the EOS Network Foundation has been working adamantly towards repairing the current narrative. EOS now has what is required to effectively market itself internally, but more importantly, externally by leveraging the EOS Network Foundation as a central point of communication. We are working with global marketing and branding firms to help us guide us and position EOS towards a better, brighter future.This work is crucial so that we've employed the best and brightest in the space so that EOS is supported by exceptional talent. Changing the narrative comes one day at a time. And I'm confident that looking back in a few months, we'll be able to see this work being reflected in token price sentiment.
因此 ,EOS 网络基金会将品牌推广和营销工作列为重中之重，并在早期投放了大量的资源。纵观过去几年 EOS 品牌的塑造和营销都比较糟糕，有些原因之前我们已经提到了，所以我们非常注重品牌推广和营销工作。我很高兴可以跟大家分享 EOS 网络基金会一直以来为了修正口碑而做出的种种努力。 通过发挥 EOS 网络基金会的沟通平台作用， EOS 现在已经具备内外部有效营销所需要的一切条件。我们也正在和全球营销品牌公司洽谈合作，请他们帮助指导和定位 EOS 的光明未来。这项工作非常重要，因此我们聘请了该领域最优秀最杰出的专家来打造 EOS 品牌和营销。当然罗马不是一天建成的，相信几个月之后再回顾今天，我们将会看到品牌价值在 EOS 代币价格上的直观表现。
Speaking of which, what excites me the most is what I believe that there's a tremendous upside to the EOS token compared to other tokens. Those doing technical analysis seem to agree. EOS has not benefited from the rise in overall market size. The token itself has been lacking behind its peers in big part because of the narrative and branding.This presents a massive opportunity for those that are still in EOS and those that are looking to invest. Recognizing that there's a lot of work that's been done and there's still a lot of work that needs to be done until we turn around, and this will take some time, I'm working towards being able to create the conditions that are needed for this token to reach a tipping point once all the pieces fall into place. The opportunities for those that remain and those that invest in EOS at this time could be massive. I hope each and every one of you sees that there's a role that you can play.
说到这里，最让我兴奋的是，我相信 EOS 代币和其他代币相比具有巨大的优势。那些做技术分析的专家学者目前都认为 EOS 并没有从市场规模的扩大中受益，它在很大程度上由于自身发展和品牌塑造等原因而落后于其他的加密货币。这其实反过来给 EOS 生态内部建设者和想要投资 EOS 的投资者们提供了巨大的获利机会。我意识到这个过程还需要付出很大的努力，而且这个转变也需要一定的时间。想理清要开展的种种工作，完成转变，这些都需要时间，而我正在努力创造这样的时间，为我们代币的崛起创造条件。一旦万事俱备，达到临界点，将看到从量变到质变的过程。对于 EOS 自始至终都保持坚定状态和此时正在投资 EOS 投资者而言，这个机会是巨大的。我希望在参会的每一位朋友都是其中的一份子。
As I present myself publicly today, I stand with certainty. My purpose is clear and without doubt.As leader of the EOS Network Foundation, I will give and lead the community in fulfilling the limitless potential that EOS holds. My vision is bold, yes, and not without controversy. Every day, the EOS Network Foundation is winning hearts and minds, but I'm not here to win hearts. That is for others. My purpose is to fill the void of leadership. Future-facing, onward-looking, and opinionated I may be,But indecisive, I am not. My leadership will make the EOS ecosystem thrive once more. But I alone cannot succeed in this task. Together, as a community, we can deliver an extraordinary revolution for EOS. I believed that in 2017, and I firmly believe it here today. Our actions have propelled and inspired a new wave of collectivism within the community.As I conclude my words, I leave you with this message. Today is the genesis of what EOS has the capacity to become. There are no more excuses. There are no more roadblocks. We have everything we need. What becomes of EOS next is simply what we make of it. Thank you.
在今天这次公开演讲上，我的态度始终是坚定不移且目标明确的。作为 EOS 网络基金会的领导者，我将引领社区发挥 EOS 的无限潜力。我的愿景挺大胆的，而且也并非没有争议。每天 EOS 网络基金会都在赢得更多人的认可和支持，但我不是来赢得人心的。我的作用是来填补领导的空白。我这个人可能是比较面向未来的，向外探索的，固执己见的，但我绝对不是优柔寡断的。我相信通过我的领导，我的引导将使 EOS 生态系统再次繁荣，但我一个人没有办法完成这项任务。作为一个社区，我们可以共同为 EOS 带来一场非凡的革命。我在2017年就相信，今天我也坚信，我们的行动已经推动并激发了社区内新一轮的集体主义浪潮。 到了我演讲的尾声，希望大家记住，今天将是 EOS 未来诞生一切的创举的起点。我们不再有什么借口，也不再有什么障碍，我们已经万事俱备。 EOS 的未来就是我们为它创造的未来。谢谢大家。 Thank you, Yves, for your excellent speech. 非常感谢 Yves 的发言。让我们对 EOS 网络基金会成立的初衷和未来规划都有了更加清晰、更加深刻的理解。这里还想提醒大家，在发问题的时候，最好可以把名字改成邀请函上的名字，这样名字一致，方便我们日后的统计。非常感谢。那接下来我们还有一位重磅级嘉宾 ，EOS 网络基金会 Communications Director Zach Gao 将为大家介绍 EOS 网络基金会的组织架构，能够为 EOS 社区提供的帮助，以及 EOS 网络基金会的决策治理流程。精彩内容，我们再次一起聆听。Handing it over to Communications Director Zach Gao, he will walk us through the structure of this organization and the collaborative support to the community.
Thank you, Daisy. Good evening to everyone. Thank you all for joining us tonight, wherever you are. I'm Zach Gall, the Director of Communications with the EOS Network Foundation, and I'm going to be speaking to you today about how the ENF is currently structured as an organization within the EOS ecosystem, how we are taking a multi-pronged approach to scaling our efforts within the EOS community, and how you all have the opportunity to play a critical role in those efforts.
大家晚上好，非常感谢大家参加本次见面会。我是 Zach Gao， 是 EOS 网络基金会的市场传媒总监。今天我将和大家讨论的是 EOS 网络基金会作为 EOS 生态系统中的一份子，我们将如何采取多管齐下的方法，努力扩大 EOS 社区的影响力，以及在座的所有人如何获得机会，在 EOS 生态发展中发挥关键作用。
EOS is a constantly evolving ecosystem, and its flexibility has always been one of its biggest strengths. This is made possible because of both its underlying technology and also because EOS is and always has been a DAO, or a decentralized autonomous organization. Let me explain what I mean. The EOS token is the payment token for claiming pro rata access to the network's resources.When it is staked in the REX, it also serves as a pro rata claim on the profits generated by the network, as well as granting pro rata access to governance rights over the network. EOS, the network itself, is a decentralized operating system governed by a DAO for applications built on a distributed ledger. If you break down the different layers of governance on EOS, you could begin with the EOS token itself. There are a billion tokens in circulation,all owned by a decentralized group of tens of thousands of independent token holders. Each token holds governance rights to determine who secures the EOS network by voting for block producers, either directly or indirectly through mining pools. The block producers themselves are centralized entities that operate nodes, which run the software and underpin the security and operations of the network itself.The top 21 nodes are responsible for block production, but they're also delegated with the guardianship over the network. Any updates to the network or to its system contracts is done in a decentralized fashion, which requires a 15 out of 21 consensus amongst the BPs. The top 21 are essentially the custodians of the EOS DAO. And for 3 years, they held the highest level of leadership within the network. However,They've traditionally been uncoordinated.
灵活性一直都是 EOS 的一个巨大优势。EOS 是一个 DAO， 也就是去中心化的自治组织，一直都是这样一个组织。我来解释一下是什么意思。作为支付代币 ，EOS 代币持有者被要求按照比例使用网络资源。当代币抵押到 REX 的时候，系统也是根据网络产生的利润按比例分配，以及按比例授予对网络本身的治理权。EOS 网络本身是一个去中心化的操作系统，由一个建立在分布式账本上的应用程序的 DAO CIO 来管理。要细分一下 EOS 的不同治理层，可以从 EOS 代币本身出发。目前市场中大约有10亿枚 EOS 代币正在流通，这些代币由成千上万去中心化的独立持有人所拥有，每一个代币持有人都拥有治理权，持币者可以直接投票或者通过矿池间接投票给区块生产者，来决定谁来确保 EOS 的网络安全。区块生产者本身是集中式的实体，他们操作着节点，而这些节点运行软件以支撑 EOS 网络运转和安全。按票数排名的前21位节点负责人，他们负责区块生产，并且获得对网络的监护权。网络系统更新、智能合约的任何更新也都是以去中心化的方式进行，这需要21个出块节点，这21个 BP 达成至少15票以上的共识。三年来他们一直都是这样做的。
Enter the EOS Foundation. Under the previous model, EOS lacked a few critical elements that held it back from reaching its full potential. It lacked leadership.It lacked coordination. It lacked the ability to effectively allocate pooled resources to advance the network itself and its own vested interests. With the ENF, we now have all three. And we've proven over just the last 2 months that we are able to execute with the speed, precision, and efficiency that simply didn't exist before.The EOS Network Foundation is a result of an even higher level of consensus than what we had ever had previously within the network. The ENF is the end result of a decision made by the top 21 guardians who secure the EOS DAO to empower the EOS Foundation with a recurring annualized budget of 20 million EOS equal to $100 million USD every year from the network itself.To lead EOS into a new era of prosperity and growth under its unified vision and stewardship of those assets. Those funds are being deployed in a coordinated and supervised fashion on behalf of EOS, within EOS, and for EOS. For the first time in the history of decentralized governance, a top-down leadership was elected by the network itself.To essentially act as the CEO of that network. We are the consensus of the network. No other protocol in existence has anything like this, where a leadership was elected and funded by the network itself. And who could also, on the other hand, be fired by the network if it doesn't perform up to the network standards. We work for the EOS token holders.We're accountable to the EOS token holders, and we are fully committed to exceeding the EOS token holders' high expectations.
EOS 网络基金会横空出世，在以前的模式下 ，EOS 缺乏一些关键的因素，使其没有办法发挥潜力。那有一些缺失的因素，包括领导、协调以及有效汇集和分配资源，以推动网络本身发展、维护生态参与者权益的能力。有了 EOS， 我们的行动，有了 EOS 的网络基金会，我们的行动就可以扭转这一局面，使其变得更加迅速和高效。相较于之前 ，EOS 网络基金会能够更高水平地进行共识决策。ENF 也就是 EOS 网络基金会是由 EOS 网络21位出块节点共同决定产生，这21个出块节点是 EOS DAO 安全的顶级守护者。21个出块节点授权 EOS 网络基金会从 EOS 网络本身获得1亿美元的年度预算，并在统一的愿景和管理下带领 EOS 进入一个繁荣增长的新阶段。为了 EOS， 它是由 EOS 来产生，由 EOS 管理，为了 EOS 提供 EOS 获益的这样一个组织。在去中心化治理的历史上， EOS 网络基金会是第一个获得自上而下支持的领导层。我们是 EOS 网络的共识，我们的角色就相当于 EOS 网络的 CEO， 这在现存的其他协议中是绝无仅有的。EOS 网络基金会作为领导层，是由 EOS 网络本身选举出来，又是自己资助的。而且如果表现达不到 EOS 网络的标准和预期，也可以被 EOS 网络解雇。 作为 EOS 代币持有者，我们的工作就是要对 EOS 代币持有者负责，超出预期的实现 EOS 代币持有者的愿望。
For EOS to be successful, the ENF cannot take on every issue or attempt to solve every problem by ourselves. We are here to empower the network stakeholders, including yourselves, to join us in our efforts to allow us to scale horizontally and in parallel so that we could all work together to drive the network forward effectively and efficiently. Fortunately, we've spent years within the EOS ecosystem as leaders of the community within the community, and we understand many of the needs and have already identified much of the top talent that are able to assist us in these efforts. There are many amazing talents still within the EOS ecosystem who have essentially been on a 3-year job interview, and we will be leaning on them heavily in our efforts moving forward. We are providing these teams and individuals with the opportunity to show the wider blockchain ecosystem just how great they really are when incentives are aligned. The ENF made an initial investment of over $1 million to assemble sponsored working groups consisting of the upper echelons of leadership within the EOS ecosystem within their areas of expertise. Each of these working groups is being tasked with defining roadmaps to solve many of the biggest and most impactful challenges that EOS currently faces as we continue to deliver on our mission to enable developers, businesses, and individuals to build on EOS. We are doing this by improving on things like wallets, user onboarding, APIs, history solutions, documentation, education, subsidized auditing, and more. As Yves had mentioned earlier, each of these 4 working groups will be delivering blue papers over the next 8 to 12 weeks, which will serve as roadmaps for EOS's future. EOS has renewed hope and optimism, which has largely been absent over at least the last 2 years. For a long time, there was not much to look forward to, and the network stagnated. The ENF is bringing renewed hope and opportunities to the EOS network. EOS is rapidly becoming an ecosystem full of limitless opportunities.
EOS 想要成功， EOS 网络基金会不可能自己承担所有问题或者试图解决所有问题。我们在这里要赋权全网的利益相关者加入我们，一起横向扩展，共同努力，切实高效地推动网络向前发展。幸运的是，我们已经在 EOS 生态系统中工作了很多年，了解其中许多需求，并且已经确定了许多能够协助我们的顶尖人才。其中许多人基本拥有3年在 EOS 生态系统的经验，也已经证明了他们的实力。我们知道他们中许多人的努力，并且已经和他们构建了合作关系，由基金会所赞助，共同着力解决 EOS 网络目前面临的多项重大挑战，比如说钱包、用户导流、API、历史解决方案、历史文档、教育、审计等等。Eve 刚才也提到，在这四个工作组中，都将分别在未来8到12周内提交一份蓝皮书，作为 EOS 未来的路线图。EOS 重新燃起了希望和乐观的情绪，在过去2年中基本上没怎么出现过。之前很长一段时间里， EOS 生态都没有什么可期待的，网络处于停滞不前的状态，而 EOS 网络基金会为 EOS 网络带来了新的希望和机会。
In our first 2 months, we've already allocated over $3.5 million in recognition grants to projects who have been building on EOS despite lacking network-wide support for a very long time. Many of these projects had low morale over the future of EOS, and they were lacking resources. EOS could not afford to lose any more talent while the ENF works to rebuild the faith in the network, so prioritizing these projects was of the utmost importance. Based on conversations I've had with the teams, they're very excited about the direction for EOS and the new opportunities that are being constantly created. They all understand that there are much brighter days ahead for EOS under the leadership of the ENF. We will not let them down. We've also funded Eden with nearly $2 million to experiment with fractal governance and decentralized identity. They've recently incentivized over 150 people to reach consensus in an election process to determine how those funds would be budgeted. The election resulted in an EOS customer support team being empowered. a grassroots marketing team with global representation, a decentralized social media platform, as well as funding for EOS onboarding, user onboarding, among other smaller efforts. And most recently, we've announced a grant matching pool of $500,000 for Pomelo. This capital will be distributed across all grant proposals made using a quadratic formula to allow the EOS token holders themselves to dictate how the public goods funding is to be allocated rather than the ENF ourselves. The ENF will continue to focus on high level, high impact initiatives while empowering the EOS community to also work independently towards our unified vision.
在我们的头两个月工作中，我们已经拨出了340万美元， 以表彰那些坚持在EOS生态基础上进行建设的项目。虽然已经很长时间他们都没有得到支持， 其中很多项目对EOS的未来发展正是其低落， 并且面临着资源缺乏的困境。我们在很长一段时间一直缺乏对这个网络的支持， 网络基金会努力重建对全网的信心时， EOS不能再流失人才了，所以优先考虑这些项目是非常重要的事情。 从我最近和这些团队的谈话中看出， 他们对EOS的新方向和正在创造的新机会都感到非常兴奋， 我们也尽力不会让他们失望的。 我们还在为Eden 提供了超过100万美元的资金， 这笔资金激励了150多个人在选举过程中达成共识， 来确定这些预算基金将如何使用。 这次选举的结果是一个EOS客户支持的团队得到了授权， 一个具有全球代表性的基层营销团队得到了资助， 还用于赞助改善新入驻用户在EOS生态的方式， 以及其他一些比较微小的努力。 最近 我们还宣布为Pomelo提供50万美元的资金， 以成立一个资助匹配池。 这笔资金将用二次融资的方式 来匹配给所有申请提案的项目， 从而让EOS代币持有者 可以自己决定如何分配公共基础产品的资金， 而不是由EOS网络基金会本身。 EOS网络基金会将会继续专注高水平 高影响力的举措， 同时授权EOS社区独立的 朝着能够共同发展的愿景继续努力。
Pomelo is a crowdfunding platform that uses quadratic voting, which was first introduced by Vitalik Buterin and has been adopted by a project called Gitcoin on Ethereum. It's proven to be the mathematically optimal way for funding public goods in a democratic community where the number of contributors matter more than the actual amount being contributed. Pomelo is the EOS equivalent of Gitcoin for funding public goods within the EOS ecosystem. Outside of Ethereum, there is nothing else like this being done anywhere. Not on Matic, not on BSC, not on Polkadot, not on Avalanche, not on Solana, not anywhere else, just EOS and Ethereum. I believe that it'll be a powerful tool for pushing EOS forward by funding and empowering hundreds and eventually thousands of individuals to be incentivized to work within the EOS ecosystem. Pomelo will demonstrate a truly sustainable and decentralized model for building public goods for the open web that will lead EOS to mature into the best in class blockchain ecosystem that we've always expected it to be. With funding allocations from the ENF for both Eden and Pomelo, they allow anyone the opportunity to be incentivized to work within the EOS ecosystem to drive it forward, and for those individuals to be paid for their time and effort, as long as other EOS token holders agree that the work that they are doing is valuable. This includes marketing, open source code, community building, education, hosting events, hackathons, and other value adds for EOS. These mechanisms are what are allowing the EOS DAO to be run more like a business, with many different individuals, entities, and businesses all working together in parallel to fulfill the unified vision for EOS being laid out by the ENF. We are steadfast in our dedication and commitment to fulfill our mission to enable developers, businesses, and individuals to build on EOS. Funding proposals for Pomelo open up on November 7th, and I would like to personally invite all of you to check it out if you're interested in supporting the EOS ecosystem in an impactful way. as we lead the network into a new era of prosperity and growth.
Pomelo 是一个使用二次融资的众筹平台，它由 Vitalik Buterin 率先提出，并且以以太坊项目Gitcoin 来采用。它已经被证明是在民主社区中，在资助公共基础设施产品中最佳的数学表现方式。在这个社区里面，贡献者的数量反而比实际资助的金额更重要。Pomelo 就相当于 EOS 生态的 Gitcoin。是用于资助 EOS 生态系统内的公共设施产品和建设。除了以太坊之外，在任何其他的区块链网络上都没有在做这样的事情，只有 EOS 和以太坊。我相信这是一个非常强大的工具，通过资助和授权在 EOS 生态系统内建设的数百人以及数千人，它能够激励并推动 EOS 的发展。通过 EOS 网络基金会的资金分配，任何人都可以加入 Eden 和 Pomelo， 并且有机会在 EOS 生态系统中以工作以推动它的发展。只要其他 EOS 代币持有者认为他们所做的工作是有价值的，这些人就可以从他们时间和精力的付出中获得相应的报酬。这些付出包括市场营销、开放源代码、社区建设、教育、举办活动、黑客马拉松等等和其他一系列对 EOS 的增值工作。这些相关机制都使得 EOS 像 DAO 一样 DAO 一样的运行，更像一个企业，许多不同的个人、实体和企业都在并行工作，以实现 EOS 网络基金会为 EOS 制定的统一愿景。我们坚定不移地致力于履行我们的使命，使开发者、企业和个人都能够在 EOS 生态系统上添砖加瓦。Pomelo 的资金提交提案通道将于11月7日正式开放。如果您有兴趣以有效的方式来支持 EOS， 带领网络进入繁荣增长的新时代，欢迎大家届时深入了解。
I mentioned earlier how EOS had previously lacked hope and optimism over the last 2 years. With all of the work the ENF is doing internally, along with its direct investments, sponsored working groups, Eden initiatives,and grant funding through Pomelo, there are countless things to look forward to and be hopeful about. This is the environment that I want to nurture within the EOS ecosystem. We want to create an environment where there is so much happening within the EOS ecosystem that it becomes impossible to even keep up with it all. We want to create an environment where there is always something to look forward to in the future that unites us all together as a community that we could all rally behind.If you'd like to join us to make this happen and keep up on everything discussed today, then I highly encourage you to join us on the EOS Community Discord channel. You could reach out directly. And I just want to thank all of you for joining today's event. And please follow us. Please join the movement as we enter a new era for EOS, as we show the world a comeback story of a lifetime.
我在前面提到 EOS 生态在过去两年中是如何缺乏乐观和希望，那随着 EOS 网络基金会的种种努力，以及我们直接投资赞助的工作组 Eden 倡议和通过 Pomelo 提供的拨款，我们相信 EOS 生态有无数充满希望的事情值得期待。这就是我们想要在 EOS 生态系统中创建的环境。在这个环境中， EOS 生态系统会发生许多非常多的事情，并且日新月异，飞速发展，甚至其他网络无法跟上 EOS 基金会的发展步伐。在我们努力构建的这个环境中，未来总有一些值得期待的事情，可以把我们所有人都团结在一起，成为社区的支持者。如果你想加入我们来实现这一目标，或者想了解今天讨论的这一切，那么我强烈建议你加入我们的 EOS 社区 Discord 频道，在那里我们可以作为一个完整的生态系统来汇聚在一起。最后，非常感谢大家参加今天的活动，号召大家积极加入我们，加入我们这场运动，让我们向世界演绎一场精彩的生态付出故事。